going to discuss about discharge of a noxious apparatus. In this video, we are going to discuss about its application, its body parts, its working and its calculations. So the main application of this apparatus is we can use it to study the discharge over different types of noxious. Now let's talk about its body parts. First of all, there is a storage tank. This is flow control valve. This is water pump. This is controller. This is small channel. This is spillway. This is measuring tank. This is outlet. This is pointer gauge. This is rectangular notch, and we can use triangular notch also. This is spillway. Now let's talk about its working part. Firstly, we will fill the storage tank. Then we will start the pump, and water will flow in small channels. After the water gets filled up to the bottom of the rectangular notch, we will take the initial reading of F from here. Now we will adjust the pointer gauge. The point should be on the surface of the water level. And here we get the initial reading of H, which is 180 mm. At this time, the water pump and flow control valve should be kept closed. Now we will again start the motor. And now we have to again adjust the pointer gauge. Here we get the final reading of S, which is 150 mm. So we can calculate the value of capital H from this pointer gauge. Now water will flow through this path. And now we will take the timer to note down the time. Initially the measuring tank is empty, so we will take the R1 reading. After that, the timer is on for some particular time period, and we will let the measuring tank to fill for that time period. Like this, we can fill the measuring tank. After that, we will take the R2 reading from here, and that's how we can take further readings. And that's how this experiment is performed. Let's talk about its calculation part. First of all, we have to form an observation table for rectangular notch. We can calculate it for V notch also. Here H0 is the initial value of pointer gauge, H is the final value of pointer gauge, R1 is the initial reading of measuring tank, R2 is the final reading of measuring tank, T is the time taken to fill the measuring tank. We can calculate the value of capital H also. Capital H is equal to H0 minus H upon 100. Capital H is water level above the crest height. We can calculate it for capital R also. Capital R is equal to R1 minus R2 upon 100. Capital R is equal to rise of water level in measuring tank. We can calculate Q also. Q is equal to A into R upon T. Q is the discharge. And we can calculate CD also. CD is the coefficient of discharge. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to the apparatus, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, you can go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, like, share, subscribe to our channel.